Right, so I forgot to tell you earlier, didn't I?
2 seconds.
Okay, so we've got a delivery coming in from Thailand this week.
We do.
We were expecting it to rock up, what, Thursday night, I think?
Yeah.
Obviously, it's coming in by air freight. Got to go through all the rigmarole, the checking, APHA, etc., etc. Mm-hmm. Picking it up at the airport. As far as we knew at the beginning of the week, probably going to be picking it up on Friday, Manchester airport, bish bosh, done. So I spoke to the clearance agent yesterday, day before, getting it all sorted, sending them, you know, all the documentation that's required. You know, everything's been booked in with APHA ready to check it all. So earlier on today, I says to him, right, so just looking at this tracking number on the airway bill, it's sort of saying that it's going to rock up on Wednesday morning, and it will be available on Thursday morning, so 24 hours after it's arrived. And he's like, oh no, that don't mean that. What that means is that it's leaving Frankfurt, because obviously it goes from Thailand to Frankfurt. So it's leaving Frankfurt on a lorry, and it takes 24 hours to rock up into the UK.
No. I don't pay for that.
Exactly.
I pay for fucking air freight.
Exactly. So this is a new one on me. So the flight that it's been popped on in Thailand has landed at Frankfurt. The initial plan apparently was to bang it on a lorry Thursday morning, or Wednesday morning, sorry, and then it would rock up into the UK Thursday morning at Manchester Airport, and then go through all the customs clearance at Manchester Airport after it's got there on a lorry.
How are they allowed to do that?
I don't know. But bearing in mind, don't forget, it's fucking roasting. We're obviously going through a heat wave. And I'm like, well, it's obviously not going to be, you know, a refrigerated container. They're just going to throw it on and away you go, aren't they?
That's fucking... Yeah. It's not even that for me. It's the fucking money you pay for air freight.
Yes.
It's like, it's fucking eye-watering.
Yes, it is.
It's eye-watering. You don't... I know the sellers know that.
You don't want to know how much this one is. But anyway...
Do I want to know? Do you want to know?
Well, 1,200 quid.
Is that just the import?
That's
flight.
Just the flight.
That's it? Not the import tax, that's
the flight. That's the flight. Yes. Yeah. It's
great. Is that dollars or?
Don't really make much difference, does it? Okay, now. I know, how are like, oof, okay. Because obviously we know prices are going through the roof because.
Prices are going through the roof,
you know, there's not many flights. So I think if we'd have sent it to Heathrow, then it would have been cheaper. But fucking hell, it's a 10 hour trip, isn't it?
Fuck, dude.
Mm.
Ugh.
Yeah, it's kind of like.
Sick.
Yeah, and don't forget we get import duty and tax and shit and everything on top of that as well. So 1,500 quid back time you finish paying it.
I assume it's not on a fucking lorry. And you're not telling me right now.
So, yeah. So, I check the tracking number and I'm like, so I question this. I'm like, so it's coming on a lorry. I'm like, well, that ain't good enough. But why does it say that it's a flight from Frankfurt to Manchester, giving it a flight number? So he came back probably about 20 minutes after and went, oh, right. No, yeah. You're right. That is actually coming on a flight and not on a lorry. Right, okay. He says, so it's rocking up tomorrow morning. So this is Wednesday. And it should be done and tested and checked by sort of Wednesday evening. So now obviously we're 2 days, we're getting the plants 2 days prior to what we would have done if it was on a lorry.
And to clarify, this is the fucking 8 to 900.
Yeah, this is plants. Yeah, this is a big fuck off order, yeah. So it's like, well, what? Seriously? So what? Agent doesn't know what he's doing? Is it up to us to bloody check this shit? Because don't forget, he would have booked the inspection in for Friday or Thursday, whenever it rocks up. So it wouldn't have even got inspected until Thursday. It's just a fucking nightmare of this shit.
It's not fucking cool for the amount of money you pay for this.
Mm-mm.
It's fucking not.
It really isn't.
I don't know if anybody knows watching this, but there's kind of two ways to do this. One is to kind of slap them in the post,
yep.
So to speak, and it still probably, I guess it still gets on an aeroplane.
Yeah, it's just super delayed,
isn't
it?
But not in the same way. This is like an overnight flight at the other end. They get inspected, they get signed off, and they get released very quickly. So you can get plants in like 24 to 48 hours from sending them. Really.
Theoretically, yeah.
Usually, on a good day, which is obviously what we're paying for right now.
Absolutely.
But fuck.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's not
I know.
Right.
So it could have all been a major disaster if I'd not been just like, well, wait a minute. Surely there's a flight number.
Plants would have probably died.
Wouldn't
that's
be
not
great.
A small order of plants.
No, it's not. Fuck. Honestly.
I want to be able to rely on people, especially people that do that fucking job.
No.
And you pay all that money to.
Yeah. I don't. Yeah, obviously, because we're paying the fucking import agent, obviously. So it's another one of the things.
I would not
like,
pay that guy if he put my shit on a lorry.
It's not him doing that, this is the airline doing that. I says, so it is...
But how can an airline put something on a fucking lorry?
I know this.
Do you not have planes?
I know this.
Was there a shortage of
planes? Obviously cheaper, isn't it? But
you can't fucking do that.
I know that.
What, so I'm paying 1,200 for a flight and you're not even going to fucking put it on?
Yeah. I know. But even at that stage, it's like, well... I can't understand it. So I says to the guy, like, well, is this normal for... Says, oh yeah, they do that all the time. It's all right because it's only 24 hours. It's like, well, if you're on a fucking flight, it'd be there in two.
Yeah.
So that's not acceptable to me. So we're literally getting the plants at least 24 hours earlier than we would have done. At least, probably even 36.
Good.
If it clears,
great.
Of course. Great, excellent.
I can't believe that.
That's a new
is
one,
that even
that.
Tea? Like, does shops know that? Honestly?
I don't know.
I mean, like, the shops know that when you pay for air freight, shit's probably going to go out, right? I bet they fucking don't.
I've never had that before. We've never had that before. That's not normal, as far as I'm concerned, but they do it. So they can just stick that air freight up their ass from now on.
I might have to blank out that name.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think you're going to have to, yeah.
I'm not getting sued.
Fuck them, honestly.
I can't afford it because I'm paying for the fucking flights that you're
exactly.
putting my stuff on.
Yeah. Bollocks to them, man.
Fuck's sake.
Anyway, it's getting dark. Got wiring to do. Don't want to fuck that up, do I?
Some plants.
Yeah, but not so many.
Nearly there. I'm a bit sick of Jerry Horn now. I loved it an hour ago. Don't love it so much.
I kind of like them.
No, they're fucking beautiful. Mm. Beautiful, beautiful plants. They just have the best leaf shape. They're lovely. I like them. They can stay.
So it's been a little while since I've filmed. It's probably been a few days, I would say. I haven't been filming because my parents have been with me helping me out, and it's been a little bit hectic to film. So I'm just going to show you what happened yesterday because it's awesome. Is it not, Ben? Branding! This is the branding that, well, I think I actually planned this from day one. This is the branding that I was after. Mirrored fronting and a lovely black design. So we got branded now. What do you think?
Yeah, it looks great. I love it.
Love it?
Yeah.
Should we go in? So in here, a few things have happened. For one thing, we got these boxes that we're going to be sitting the plants in. Just a couple of bits of furniture being added, really. Nothing's arranged yet. This is going to be my desk. It's not necessarily going to be here. I added this because I liked it in IKEA. I saw it. I liked it. There was a good deal on it. I bought it. It's added a little bit of a spanner into the works in terms of decorating this room, because beforehand there was probably just enough space, whereas now there's probably not enough space. But I really like it and I want it there. So I'm gonna have to think of a way to get it there and have it not cramped. That's basically what's gone on in here. So it looks a bit hectic, but it's basically just about getting the furniture up. We have power. Oh my God, I didn't even mention we have power. So we were in here about two nights ago doing some work, and we must have finished at about 11 o'clock. And we didn't check the entire time if there was power. And we were doing work with like camping lights and phone torches and stuff, walking around in the back. And we only realized before we left that we had power. So whilst awesome, it was pretty hilarious that we've done a whole shift of like 6 hours with no power again. In here, it's getting a bit much. Yeah, needless to say, it's getting a bit much, right? It's
filling up.
There's a lot. Some plants have lost a couple of leaves over there from acclimating, I think, to the new place. Or just the stress, to be honest, because it's getting ridiculous. But generally, everything is fine. So the living wall stuff is still here because we're behind, like, the house, right? So in here we've got some stuff. Some stuff is taking a dive. Some stuff is fine. It would be okay. This stuff, back in the day when I started my shop, used to stress me out a lot when I see yellow leaves and stuff, but it's just the way it goes. It's part and parcel of doing this. It's horrible, but you've just got to get used to it. And eventually you do get used to it. That's why if I get plants with yellow leaves, I don't really panic. It's just like, yeah, well. Again, not much has changed in here. There's just shit everywhere, to be honest, isn't there? The main update is up here, to be honest, so Ben will have to follow me up. Careful. Oh my God, secrets! No! It's not a secret. They're in here on the couch. I'll explain in a second. So this is currently what my studio looks like. There's been a lot of work on it, but my parents have done a lot of the work. You haven't really seen it, but I'm gonna update you now. The shell is kind of done, I would say. So I don't know if the camera's blown out. It's all right. Right, to quickly explain, we changed a few things. We finally boxed off this window here all the way along the bottom to make it look a little bit more like part of the wall. Nothing has been cleaned. It's still dusty as hell. Up here, we've done the beams totally differently, to be honest, to what we said we would. They have been stained and everything else. And we put a wood trim around the top just so it feels a little bit more like a room. Obviously, the skirting board's on as well. We have a light switch right here that does nothing because there's no light. My sofa, which is the sofa bed, actually. Oh, it's the first time sitting on it, believe it or not. It's nice. It's quite upright. It feels really upright, though. Like that. I can film and sleep on this because it is a sofa bed. And I've bought something for the wall behind me so I can film in front of this sofa and it will look sickening. So I bought something called Nano Leaf. It's basically just some lights that you clip together and you can make patterns out of them. So this here is a light. This is not sponsored, by the way. I sunk my own money into these things, and they were expensive. I have no shame in it. I've always wanted some of these, but I thought now was the time. So you can kind of clip them together in a pattern and make pretty colors, basically. So I'm gonna put something, some kind of design on the back of the sofa, either a design that goes upwards or probably what I would prefer, something nice and long. And that's basically all that's gonna be on this wall. Maybe a plant here, a plant here, sofa, done. The other side of the wall, I still don't know what I'm doing, but I have one of these and I don't know how to pronounce it. It's not chaise longue. Chaise longue?
Chaise. Is it?
It is a different colour from the sofa, personally. I knew that. I think it's fine. But that's kind of the update, really. I don't know what else I can update you on. Oh, we moved a heater.
Yes.
Most random news ever. We moved the heater from down here to up here just to basically accommodate for some more shelves. Anyone that is worried about the safety aspect of what's going on behind me, this is going to have railings. They're currently being made, so they're going to be fitted in the next few days, I think. So this will all be nice and safe as well. I think that's kind of it, isn't it really, dude? So yeah, back to work.
Filming me. Film your back.
It's quite big, isn't it?
Yeah, do you not think it will be?
They are big.
It's kind of thin though.
It's nice.
I'll use my muscular body to move this fucker. It's a fucking heaviest fridge I've ever moved.
Come here, bitch. Get
the fucking fucker away, like I'm being nice.
The labels are absolutely shit. Mate, black labels.
Yeah, we'll get some proper labels on.
Top two rows are snacks, but they are double coils, so you can get like crisps in, basically. Or like maybe like a family pack of
Bag.
What are they called? So next two drawers here are for chocolate, or as it's known in the USA, candy. And then the bottom. So the bottom drawer here is for regular cans, like, you know, Pepsi, Coke, Fanta, whatever your poison is. And this is not my fault. This is 100% Ben's fault. But this next drawer up is for what, Ben? You can't say that, it's a brand name.
Oh, fuck. It's beer. That's the beer shelf.
We are not doing that.
I think this is enough.
By the time you see this,
yes.
It's crunk. Yeah. Vending machine. This boy.
Beautiful.
you doing going back down? For the shot.
For the shot. Everything for the shot.
Right. You learned that from vlogging, dude. Didn't you?
I'm like, yeah, fuck it. I'm getting it. Dude, I'm not like 20 minutes.
I got through it, dude.
Yeah, but I'm bigger than you.
Oh my god.
Yeah, fuck. Ah, can't get any shit. I can't. I'm stuck.
Sorry,
I'm not gonna find it. I can't bend that fucking form.
Right, right, there you go.
I mean, speak with clarity.
Around us, or maybe it's just me. There's trash out in the sea, yeah, but I'm just too tired to reach it. That this might be the final update on this place. What date's it today, do we know?
1st of October, I think.
Is it the 1st of October? That's kind of cool. Okay, so this is probably the last update that you will see for this shop for maybe a little while. I would argue it's about 95% complete. Would you agree, Ben?
I would.
Yeah. So we're just going to show you around and show you kind of what it's become in the last... Well, I don't even know how long we've been doing this.
Nearly 7 months now, I think.
It's a long time. It's insane. So I guess we'll start with in here.
Okay.
So you already know I got my vending machine. Super happy. Turned it off to film. It's a little bit noisy, so we're turning it off to film. In here, I think, honestly, nearly everything I wanted happened. This was never supposed to be... Do you know what I mean? It was never supposed to be a space where I do much other than it's basically an office and somewhere where I can eat and just chill. So I think everything turned out pretty well. It's simple, it's chill, but I like it, it's nice. This is where I'm gonna be working most days when I'm down here. I'll edit, I'll do all the usual stuff here. That's kind of it for in here. Yeah. So I guess that's not really the part everyone wants to see though, is it? Let's be honest. So I'm just gonna take you through the shop as it currently stands, if Ben would like to follow me. Oh damn. It's
It's pretty crazy.
It is a little bit crazy. And the weird thing is, this place, and I know Ben agrees with me because we've spoken about this quite a lot, it doesn't feel big anymore. But it is massive, but it just, I think it's just because we've been here so often, it's just become our home. It doesn't feel big, it just feels as it should.
Yeah, it does.
Do you know what I mean?
It's comfortable.
Yeah, it's just so. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's really weird. But got everything growing. Honestly, things are growing pretty well, I would say. I think they're all right. They had a little bit of a wobble when they first came, I think, going from really hot temperatures down to lower temperatures, but they're fine. I think they're all just doing really well. Lovely little queens.
I think that's a good thing though, isn't it?
It is, because you can't... It was all very well us growing them at those temperatures, but you can't... People's houses aren't going to be that warm. They need to be hardier. So it's really only a brilliant thing that we're hardening them up like that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, 100%.
Just looking amazing. Everything's just looking great. I have to take so many propagations as well. Like... I have melanocryzum just crawling up the wall. I should probably sort that. I haven't had time, obviously. I haven't even had time to do extra propagation.
Oh.
So that's a thing as well. It's just everywhere, man. There's just ghosts for days. Just pop them up at the top. It just goes on and on. Like, I could do a tour of this place and it would last hours. Obviously, I'm not going to do that. It just goes on and on. It really, really does. Oh, look at these. These have come along leaps and bounds. Literally beautiful. Oh, I know. Some lovely pinks. Look at that.
That's a leaf and a half.
Oh, my billies. I'm loving my billies. I'm going to be really, really, really sad to see these billies go. Because I love the way that they sit on these shelves right here. They just look amazing. I don't want them to leave.
It's kind of one, isn't it? You don't actually want to sell anything, do we?
No.
It's almost like our own little jungle.
Yeah, it's beautiful in here, and I want it to be like this. I don't want to sell everything.
No.
Do you know what I mean? It's going to be really sad to see a lot of these plants go, dude.
It's really, really tough, that.
It is.
You sort of get attached to these plants. And it's not just you get attached to one, you get attached to the lot.
Yeah, like I'm not attached to this biletai, I'm attached to my biletai.
Yes, yes.
Oh, wait, there's one here as well.
The batch, and there's a few more here.
My debaya as well.
You're attached to the shelves.
Do you remember before we put some of the debaya on the wall? I think you put all the debaya on the shelves, and we just had, I don't know if I've got any footage, but they were just cascading down one shelf and it looked almost like a debaya in the wild.
It
Do you remember
fantastic.
That?
It was fantastic. It was beautiful, wasn't it?
That was so good, man. Oh, I love these. I really, really love these. Look at the size of them.
It's fantastic.
Absolutely stunning.
It's amazing that they turn into that fantastic shape.
Isn't it?
From the little bitty sort of silvery ones, isn't it?
It's absolutely beautiful. Mm. Absolutely beautiful. Look at that, man. Got so much albo on top. Just growing away, look.
Just a few bits and pieces.
Just a couple of albo, guys. Just a couple. You know? Oh, so excited about these. So excited about these. They're growing so well as well.
They do
variegated
seem to be, don't
Peru.
They?
Yeah. They're growing really, really nice. Lovely new growth. You can tell it's going to come in really pretty as well. All my dark lords coming in really nice, growing really well. More debaya. Actually, I didn't realise there was debaya here. I thought it was just
Well, you know, there's not enough frame around there, is it?
And, I mean, there's this.
Kaboom.
This is a thing that we did.
It's ridiculous. I got to walk backwards for, well, too far.
Yeah.
Can't get it in.
I don't know where to start with this. This is nothing to panic about. This is completely and utterly natural. All of these plants are currently acclimating to this wall. Things have moved, so we have some black places where they weren't before. So things are just kind of moving around and just finding their own feet. But just want to let you know that she is fine, because I just know I'm going to get a million comments going, oh my God, is she all right?
Yeah.
She's fine. So the queen has nobly sacrificed her amazing, beautiful leaf to give us this.
I'll try and get in there.
Can you see that there?
I think so.
So she's given us these beautiful aerial roots right here. So she's rooting onto the wall. And quite honestly, she's rooting onto the wall like many, many, many other plants that you see here. Pretty much every plant, I would say, that is on this wall has gone ballistic.
It really has, hasn't it?
It has gone absolutely ballistic. Well, there's a tie here that's
The tie's going crazy.
The tie's going crazy with its roots. Can you see that there?
Getting a bit wet.
You can see that there, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, they're everywhere, yeah.
They're literally...
It's crawling straight across that one.
Yeah. It's crazy. loads of new leaves all over the place. You just can't necessarily see them because honestly, they are everywhere. There's so many anthurium just hiding away.
It's the seeds and...
Seeds, just everything. Yeah. Cheeky little...
Fantastic.
I don't know how the alocasia made it into anthurium cove. But there he is. We have a little bit of acclimation occurring up here.
Yep.
So that anthurium will probably sacrifice that leaf and then it will be a stump, but it will grow a new pretty leaf on top of that. I just, I'm still in awe of the fact we even did this.
It looks fantastic.
It's weird to stand in front of it being just a wall and see it now.
Yeah.
Do you mean when you look back and you see me stood in front of it and there's nothing?
I know.
Do you know what I mean?
It's bizarre, isn't it? Even now though, that is starting to look a little bit small.
Oh yeah, so you know. People might laugh, but it feels small.
It does, doesn't it?
Doesn't it feel
it's
small?
It's really bizarre. When you see it sort of every day, it's like, whoa, yeah, oh, we could have gone bigger.
Yeah.
Come here.
Yeah, it sounds crazy, but it feels small. I think everything just feels, it's the weirdest thing. It feels so homely, even though it's so big. Everything just feels like it's supposed to be here, doesn't it?
It really does. It's kind of bizarre.
It is very bizarre. But I cannot wait to come here every morning and pull up a little camping chair, right, and sit right here.
Next marks the spot.
With a cup of tea, and I'm just going to look at my wall every day. That's what I want to do. It's so good.
It's fantastic. You've done a really beautiful job, dude.
Yeah, but dude, you helped me do this.
Yeah, but it was your design.
Yeah, but I couldn't have done this without you.
Yeah, but just look. Mess if I stuck it on.
It
would, you know that. It's design inspiration. And it looks beautiful. It's balanced. It looks great. It just looks great.
I can't wait to see it grow.
Oh.
Honestly. There are little nuggets of things on this wall that people can't see, but they are there. They're just small.
Shall we? They want to know. They want to know what's on there. Yeah, of course they do.
Okay, so I just moved Mr. Regal.
Okay.
You see a certain somebody down there? You see him there?
There you go.
He is absolutely beautiful. And I guess just above him, there's a little somebody growing out too.
What?
You see him in his little pocket. There's a little piece of eel money eye just growing away on the wall. It's really cool that, you know, because we got that whilst doing this whole process and it's been really nice to just put a little piece on the wall. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like a big treasure trove of just things that we find and we love.
I popped a UPI when over here.
Oh, no, my God. Oh, no, it's with the Queen. Yeah, I forgot all about the UPI. There it is.
Little baby one.
Yeah.
It's
growing pretty well, actually.
Yeah.
Looking pretty happy.
It's doing really, really well.
Oh, honestly, what a blessing. This wall is such a blessing. I'm never going to get tired of it.
No. I don't think you can, and I think, obviously, you know, week to week, stuff's growing.
By the time spring comes, because I will absolutely show you guys, obviously, by the time spring comes, this is just going to be ridiculous, won't it?
Yeah.
It really is. This is still in acclimation. This is still just after we put it up. This is before things properly find themselves.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, but I think...
But overall, how are you feeling?
Proud, but
really
confused.
Good. Yeah, I am, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, exhausted.
I've had a little bit of a rest, but yeah, I'm exhausted. Like as much as I would do this all over again, I am looking forward to going back to reality.
Yeah.
And getting on with it.
Indeed.
Yeah. I guess there's one more thing we should show people.
Oh.
And that would be the studio.
Indeed.
Which is right up here. So this is where I'm going to be filming not every video, but a large portion of my videos right now. Let's show you what I've done with it. So I'll let you in here. So honestly, I've kept it really minimal in here just because I want to be able to move it around. I want to be able to do whatever I want to do. So I've kept it pretty chill. I never managed to put everything in white pots.
You've got a
It'll happen, right? I'm running out of time.
All the dodgy ones.
Yeah, they're all just chilling up there. But it's really, really beautiful. I shut this door.
It looks really good, dude.
Does it look nice?
Yeah, it really does, yeah.
It's so beautiful, isn't it?
It's panning around, it's pretty nice. You could live in there, couldn't you?
Dude, I want to live in here. Yeah. I don't want to go home. I want to live in here. It's absolutely beautiful. Look at it all. All my hoya that I admittedly haven't had time to pop.
Yeah.
my lovely palm that neither of us know what it is?
Not yet.
We never found out?
No.
All my Hoya. Finally, I now have somewhere to hang my damn Hoya, and I'm loving life.
And they are actually growing.
They are growing,
really
look at
well,
that.
They?
You yeah. see that?
Yeah, yeah.
They're actually growing.
Yeah.
100%. I've got blooms coming in and everything. It's brilliant. Oh, dude, I love it. Had to take a blue star fern for myself. Had to.
It's a really nice fern, that.
Isn't it beautiful?
Yeah.
Might be my new favourite fern. I mean, probably I'll end up putting a lot more plants in here.
You will?
Maybe. I'd like to not, because I feel like it's really nice being minimal in here, and that's the idea. Mm. It's nice to have like a clear head, clean space. Maybe because I'm one of those people that prefers that, so we'll see how it goes. I don't know. Mm. There's a couple of things I'd like to put in here.
Okay.
But we'll see.
Is this a wish list coming up?
No. There's just a couple of things that I think I want to have. Plants that I used to have years ago now, or plants I used to have when I started my channel, that I've had to get rid of while I've moved houses, I think. I want some back. So I might do that. Oh, this chair. I barely sat on this chair. For anyone that doesn't know, I've barely been up here. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
I was decorating
you really
this.
Haven't. Yeah.
Yeah, I've decorated it. I haven't been in here though.
No.
I think I was here one evening. I had a little lie down on the couch and that's it. I haven't been in it. So I'm so excited to be in here and filming here. Can you remember when we were just stood here chatting and this place was like a dusty shell?
Yeah, no walls, just the window.
Yeah.
You're like,
ooh. It's nuts.
It's crazy, isn't it?
It is actually crazy what it looks like now. It's hard to think that there was nothing here. Do you know what I mean? When we came here, it was literally just a shell.
Yeah.
That's...
You've done a standout job. You really have.
Well, again, not my work. I didn't do the walls,
well,
dude. You keep saying it's me, but we did it together. Yeah. We did. Oh, I guess we could show the view from the balcony.
Oh, yes. Let's do that. Yeah, definitely.
A beautiful railings. This is it. Obviously, the lights aren't on at the minute, so it looks super dark, but it's not. There's the wonderful view that I get when I come out of my studio.
There we go.
Is it nice?
Beautiful.
It's
fantastic,
so good.
Isn't it?
Isn't it brilliant?
It kind of, when you're up here, it kind of looks like there's a lot more plants than what it does when you're down there, because you can sort of see.
Oh, really? So you can see them in their full glory now?
Yeah, tons of them now.
Yeah. Oh, and obviously.
And the wall.
I can also stand here and look at that bad boy.
Yeah, boy. Come here.
Yeah. It's fucking nuts that... It's nuts to be stood here. It's nuts for there to be railings here. It's nuts that there's plants here and they're not bloody on the floor in buckets, and when we've got the camping chairs around.
That's it.
You know?
Yeah.
Thank you. let me tell you, it has been a wild ride to get to where we are today. But I'm really glad to have experienced every second of it because it has changed me as a person. So for that, I'm really grateful. It's weird, you know, because when I started this channel, it was born from a complete intrigue and just love of plants. I had no idea that I'd be where I am today. I moved to the city where I currently live to take a job, and it was not related to plants. And I cannot believe that a year later, I've moved on to quit that job and to build my own life, my own business, develop my own passion, build my own dreams. It's really no secret that my life at the minute is very intensive and it's very hectic. And it would be fair to say that I've given a lot of time to this. Probably too much time on occasion. I've given everything for this. But honestly, I'm not sure I'd take any of it back. Because this whole process has changed me as a person in so many ways. I've become more assertive. I've become more confident. I'm more sure of myself. I've let go of old toxic friendships and I've built really strong bonds with new and amazing people. I've learned so much about myself, about business, about everything, really. And I know this is gonna sound really corny saying it, but this whole process feels like the closing of one chapter and the beginning of a new one. And this whole thing has been so hard for the past 6 months, but honestly, I don't want to take a single second of this back. I don't want to take back the tears, the laughter, the highs, the lows. I don't want to, because nothing would be the same if I changed any of those things. I would never be where I am if those things didn't happen. For that, I'm truly grateful for everything. Sitting where I am today, I'm really looking forward to the future. For the first time in a long time, I'm really looking forward to seeing what I can create. I feel like there's nothing else I can really say other than I believe the thanks are in order. Thank you so much for your kindness, your love, your support, picking me up when I'm down, guiding me where I need it. So I just want to say thank you. You just being there is such an amazing thing, and it means more to me than you could ever even know. I'm gonna go. Thank you. Hi everybody, how are you doing? I hope you're having a great day. Hello plant people, how are you doing? I hope you're having a great day. Today I thought I'd do something a little bit different. So it's finally time to show you the journey that I have been on. There's so many new plants here that I didn't even know existed. And I thought, okay, what if I did a video on like a different group of plants each video, possibly make it a series, I don't know, it depends how interested everybody is. Going from uncommon, rare, very rare, extremely rare, and holy. Hello everybody, glad you could make it. My name is Kaylee Ellen, and welcome to another episode of Rare Plant Index. You know when you're just so excited for something, like you try and keep it in? This is so special, I can't fucking even begin to describe. Oh my God, I could cry. Oh my God. This is what is known as a queen anthurium. This is like, it's pretty much top end on anthuriums. It doesn't really get too much better than this, I'll be honest with you. I genuinely have a passion to collect rare plants, as you guys know, but I thought I would take it one step further and do something that, to be honest, I've wanted to do for a long time. I don't know about anybody else, and I would be curious to know this, but a lot of plant shops just don't really have anything, you know, cool and unique in at the minute. And I have decided, and I am, opening a plant shop. Welcome to the Rare Plant Shop. So things will change, not for the, you know, the worse, but, you know, my environment will change, where and how I film might change. I might film in a completely different room. I might not film in a bedroom anymore. But let me tell you something. This channel has been a rare houseplant channel from almost its inception. And the name of my shop is the Rare Plant Shop. I'm here to tell you, that's not changing. That's not changing now. That's not changing ever. That's kind of it, right? Like now all we have to do is, well, I say all we have to do, shit's gonna get real now, really. Because now we have to prepare all of these plants. We have to take pictures of them. We have to check that they're all ready to go. We have to get all of the boxes ready to go out. There's so much to do.
Yeah.
Like this is only the beginning of it, really.
It really is. The hard work starts now.
Yeah, maybe about a month, I think, before we launch. Generally so. Do you think that we can do this? After all this?
I hope so. Jesus, you know. Be awesome. Onwards and upwards.
I'm ready. I'm not ready. Disclaimer, I'm not ready. I'm dying inside. Let's do it.
Let's do it, dude.
Let's do it. Let's launch. Let's fucking launch. We'll be right back.